Tony's, we closed the night. We've done ran out of food. Thank you for calling Tony's. We closed for the night. We're out of food.
I'm exhausted. How many more guests do we have?
None. We're shutting down.
Thank God. I don't know if I have enough energy to study for my midterm.
Yes, Lord, yes. Look at all that behind. It's all mine and fine. Baby, you look good tonight, baby. Yes, you sure do. Business is booming.
What did you do, Tony?
Oh, I thought I might just stimulate a little business, that's all.
Don't tell me it was that Groupon or whatever you be doing. I hate when you do that, because we barely make any money when you do that.
Oh, Hazel, baby, I'm just trying to gain some momentum for our anniversary party at the end of the month.
That's if we get up the cold by the end of the month.
Oh, Hazel, calm down. Listen, between this and our anniversary party at the end of the month, we'll have more than enough money.
I sure hope so.
All right. Oh, God, y'all working me to death today. Jesus Christ. Tony, why you ain't tell me about this damn promotion?
Because I'm the boss and I do as I please.
Oh, you do.
Sure do. I understand you're the boss out here, but I'm the boss in that kitchen and you got to let me know what's going on so I can be more prepared.
Listen, man, we have plenty of food. How many did we serve, Hazel?
46, and we're shutting down. All right.
46. Only made enough food for about 50 people. Come on, man.
Problem solved.
Listen, man.
Last time you pulled a stunt like this, you was late on the mortgage and you was late on my check.
Oh, man, listen.
Anthony Graves III?
Yes.
I know we're not behind on no bills.
Oh, baby, we'll cover it with this promotion. There's no sweat.
Oh, you better hope so.
I swear to God, if I don't get my money, there's going to be some consequences, repercussions, and you don't want none of this trouble. Trouble. That's... Hey, we closed.
We ain't got no
money. Don't be rude.
Ain't no more food.
Glad I ain't take it.
How she gonna serve me? She 12.
You gotta be kidding me. You must vacate the property in 30 days if you don't pay $5,656, Tony.
God, that can't be right. I was only 2 months behind.
2 months? What, you been gambling again?
This got gambling written all over it. I can still hear the dice rolling.
Everything okay?
No, get the rest of the bills. We shutting this down.
Now you're just throwing flowers and stuff on the restaurant. Baby, calm down. Listen, baby. I got everything under control, baby.
Under control?
Yes.
We shouldn't be in this predicament to begin with.
I know. I got a few tricks up my sleeve. How much did it say we owe again?
$5,656 plus $3,500 to get up the code.
Did I just hear $10,000? Geez, I just told you, I need my money. I got some sugar daddy to do this weekend.
I hope you have a plan, Tony. I really do.
Oh, baby, come. Oh, good God Almighty. Well, I got a plan.
I hope you
and,
got
I hope you got guess it. Who's going to come help me?
Who the hell going to help you, Tony?
You.
Me?
Yes, you.
Oh, hell no, I ain't helping you, Tony.
Come on, Bernard.
Hell no, none of your businesses work out right, man.
Explain? Yes.
Well, do I have to remind you about the time you tried to open up a shoe shine business on the corner for the drug dealers?
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Drug dealers don't even wear shoes. They wear Timberlands and New Balance.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Yeah, man. Then one time we shined one shoe, the money, walked around the corner, we got robbed.
But no, that wasn't our fault. That wasn't my fault. They called us slipping that day.
We had on church shoes. That's why we were slipping.
Oh, God, no, man.
What about the other time?
What other time?
You remember the other time when we had the car dealership?
Oh, don't bring up that car.
We had 16 cars.
Don't you bring up that car dealership.
We were killing it. 16 cars,
oh,
man.
Good
then Freddy Smooth came and wanted to buy the whole car lot.
I can't stand that nigga.
I know you can't because you ain't selling it. You did not sell it because you had the Cadillac.
Did you see that Cadillac?
The Cadillac was nice until the transmission went.
Oh, God.
Now we on all your grow looking for a tranny.
Who was looking for a tranny?
You was looking for a tranny.
I was looking for a transmission. You
You know what the hell I'm saying.
Oh, listen, Bernard, listen. I get where you're coming from. God knows I do, Bernard. But listen, I learned from my mistakes. It won't happen again, Bernard.
Okay, but I'm still not working with you.
But Bernard, tell me how can I get you to help me, Bernard?
You can't. That's the point of this conversation.
Bernard, tell me how can I get you to help me, Bernard?
I'm going to need a bigger cut.
A bigger what?
A C-U-T, a cut. Come on, man,
50%.
50%?
50%. You ain't Uncle Sam?
No, I'm Uncle Bernard.
Come on, Bernard.
Come on, man, deal or deal?
Oh, deal or deal? Oh, shoot. I don't got no other choice, huh?
No, deal or deal. Which one you want to do?
Oh,
take it or leave it.
I'll take the second deal, then.
All right, cool.
All right, you two in business together?
Yeah.
This should be fun to watch.
Oh, Lord. Dear God.
Call him.
I come before you, knee bowed and body bent before your holy throne of grace. If I ever need Asia, I'll buy Canada double ho shanty. If I ever needed you before, Lord knows I lead you more than ever.
Don't ask me for no money either. Ooh, this flower filter got my skin on fleek.
Hi. Hello. Hi.
Hi.
I'm Paige. Welcome to Pure Change Consulting. You must be Chanel.
Yes, I am in the flesh. You want to get in my snack?
No, I don't think Nell would be a good
time. Yeah, no, it is. Uh-huh. No. Hey, y'all, this my new boss. Don't hate. Ain't she cute? Look, this my favorite filter, the dog filter. Stick your tongue out.
No, thank you. Now, can we get on with the interview, please?
Okay,
thank you.
You can lighten up, though. You don't gotta be so uptight. This place could use some freshening up a little bit.
Excuse me?
Nothing. Look, how long you been in business?
I just got here a week ago.
Okay, yeah, look like it.
Listen, have a seat.
Okay.
Would you like any coffee water? Excuse me, hello. That's my seat, hello.
Listen, look, I got back problems, so if I'm working here, I'm gonna have to head this chair, because this is comfortable.
Okay, it's fine for now. Now let's get on with the interview, please. Thank you.
You don't gotta be so angry.
So,
yeah.
I have your interview, your resume here, and it looks quite interesting.
Oh, wait, I got a job already? Wait a minute, let me put up my Facebook post.
We haven't even started the interview.
So you got me all in my feelings thinking I got the job and whatnot?
Girl. So tell me a little bit about yourself.
I could do that. Okay, my name is Chanel Monique Watson. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes, and I'm a Leo. My favorite color is salmon. And and my favorite TV show is Family Feud, especially when black people be on there. Yup, they be like, good answer, good answer.
Okay, so what are your skills? Like, what are your skills and how do they relate to this job?
Oh, okay, all right. So I got about 4,000 followers on Twitter, so that means I'm a people person. Mm-hmm. I take about 30 selfies before I post one on Instagram, so that means I pay very close attention to detail. When I go to the club on Saturday, I make sure I am there at 11 o'clock, okay? Yeah, so that means I'm very punctual. And, if you need a personal reference, I can give you the club promoter's name and number. Let me see what else.
Is more?
Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, I did 2 years in juvie, right? Yeah, for not snitching. So that means I take confidentiality very seriously.
You can't be serious. Please tell me you're not.
Hey, look, you said you wanted to know about my skills. I mean, I got more. You want to know?
I got Snapchat. I'm okay. Thank you. You're fine.
Okay. All right, well, I got some questions for you.
Okay, go ahead.
All right. How long you been open again?
About 5 years I've been in this business.
Okay, all right. Look, I need somewhere stable, okay? Because I'm not trying to go back to being somebody temp. How long are my lunch breaks? Are they half an hour or hour? Please say they're an hour. Do I get paid sick leave? You know, because I tend to get sick every payday and every Monday. I get like, yo,
it was nice meeting you, Miss Watson. I can walk you out.
Wait, I don't have a job. Wait, please.
Listen.
Wait, please! Come on, please! I need this job, please! I can't go back to the strip club, Stevie!
Oh my God, get up! Get up! Please! Get up! All right, okay. for a probationary period of 90 days. Okay. No calling out.
Okay. You was about to hear me cry.
Listen. Don't make me change my mind.
All right, listen. So you're saying probation. Like, I can't call out at all. How about dirt bikes? Is that a violation? I mean, I just want to make sure because it's probation.
Again, don't make me change my mind.
Okay. All right. No calling out. All right, so now that I'm hired, right, we got to clean this place up.
Agreed.
Okay, good. Because, you know, just because your office is in North Philly don't mean it got to look like you are North Filthy.
Question.
Yes?
Did you really do 2 years in juvie for not snitching?
Girl, please, no. All right, look, I learned that from Scared Straight. I'm too cute to be in somebody's jail. Gotcha! So, we got to get this in order, child. Like, this is clean. It's kind of cute. Is it real? It's fake. Yes. See, you got to get real clean.
Chase, come help me with this, Chase. Come help me with this. Come here. I got it, y'all. What you got. What the slip and fall came through from the casino?
No, boy, they saw you drop that water on there and saw me gently fall down. Man, I got something even better than that, though.
Oh, man, you got to be quicker than that. Come on now.
I know.
What you got?
Listen, man, this is the answer to all our financial problems, y'all.
Talk to me. What is it? Pull it out.
Gerbil life, that's right. Everybody's in Philly selling it, and I want in.
No, I'm pretty sure that's not what they're selling, Mr. T. I'm pretty sure it's called something else.
I'm pretty sure you're supposed to have hair on your face, but you don't see me complaining, do you? Now listen, I got 50 bottles of this. Right, put your calculator out, come on. I got 50 bottles of that. I'm going to sell it for $25 a pop. That'll be a bottle.
Come on, let me see this. Side effects of gerbil life may cause dizziness, diarrhea, gout, glaucoma, and you probably won't get hard.
Boy, you sure you're not reading the ingredients of your potato salad?
No, my potato salad, I get hard all the time. What you talking about? People gonna be losing weight for real with this at a fast rate. I don't know how long you gonna be selling this.
Listen, man, well, I what do you suggest?
I mean, to be honest, if you let me run the business, I'll make sure business is booming.
Oh, all right. Okay, cool. I think so.
I'll be your first customer.
See, I told
yeah,
you.
Yeah. Give me two bottles. There you go.
Okay, take the money. We give it to you later. Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about. Shit, that boy got money and glow, just like his uncle.
Glow?
Yeah, you know glow. You know that glow when you just shine for no reason and all the women just like you. I had it all my life.
Hey, Bernard.
What's up?
Newsflash.
Uh-huh.
You ain't got no glow. You use too much hotel soap, you just ashy.
Only thing ashy around here is your voice, okay? I'll tell you like that. You need to take me down to that school, man. Give me some of them college girls. They love an old player like me.
They sure do, and guess what?
What?
When you get down there, make sure you got some lemonade.
They like juice.
Okay. Some cookies.
They like cookies. Right.
And Chris Hansen.
For what?
To catch a predator.
Man, I'm not worried about women right now, Uncle. I'm about to graduate. I gotta focus on that.
Oh, man, that boy is square just like you.
Boy, shut up, man. That boy got plenty of time, man.
Oh, man.
A few more semesters left and I'm done.
What about if you run across a dime piece? Yeah, a five-star chick. You know what I mean? What? A foxy lady, you know what I'm saying?
Foxy?
You ain't never seen Foxy Brown, the movie?
Yeah.
That girl bad as hell.
I mean, I suppose if I found a good woman, I wouldn't fight it.
Listen, man, I was just finna say that to you, young man. If you find a good woman, don't be scared of her. You know why?
Why?
She'll help you grow.
Ah, man, which is it? Either the boy got time or he don't. Make up your mind.
Look who I ran into.
Good God, put that down. Good God. Well, you sure look familiar. Good God.
Slow down. They don't love you like I love you. Hey, girl, my name is Mr. Bernard, a.k.a. Sugar Daddy, or whatever you want to call me. What's your name, Foxy?
That's funny. I can use a good laugh on my day.
Oh, no, I'm dead serious. What's your name, baby girl?
I'm Paige.
Oh, Paige.
Paige.
Paige, remember the Paige back in the day? Used to have the braids going back, no hang time. You remember that? She used to have the glasses on, bifocals.
Yeah.
And the breath used to be hot as hell. Remember that?
So hot.
Breath so hot she could light a cigarette. Remember that?
I remember that.
It could be you.
And she had on high waters back then, too.
Oh, she still got her ankles out.
Paige, that's you. Come here, Paige. Good God Almighty.
Good God. Talk about me.
Looking just like your mother. How you been doing,
baby? Oh, I couldn't be better. Just moved back from Atlanta.
Oh, you just moved back from Atlanta. Hey, Bernard. Hey, what? Philadelphia girls sure love moving to Atlanta when they tired of being a hoe up here, don't they? Yeah, Bernard. Listen. Don't want to be a hoe in Philly no more? Pack your bags and be a hoe in Buckhead.
You know what that's called, right?
What's it called?
That's called re-hocating.
I'm so sorry, man. We not talking about you, no, baby. We're not talking about you, man. We heard you moved out there with your rich boyfriend.
Yeah, we're not together anymore.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that, but give me a hug, baby girl. Tell your daddy I said hi, all right?
Paige, what would you like? I know you came back for a famous banana pudding and that homemade lemonade.
You still remember that?
That's crazy. I have the memory of an elephant.
Oh, my God.
Chase?
Yes? Yes, ma'am?
I'd like you to meet Paige. Paige, this is Chase.
Hi. It's nice to meet you.
Could you go get her a famous banana pudding and a homemade lemonade?
Yes, ma'am.
And while you're back there, get my Xanax for your nerves, boy. He's scared as hell. And make sure you get some of my Viagra. I gotta stand up early. Later on.
Hey.
I'm sorry. Apologize.
What brought you back to Philly?
Oh,
PHI 215.
I figure I opened up my new business here, a financial firm.
Nice.
It's better opportunities here, I think.
Yeah, you should have kept your butt in Atlanta. Ain't nothing here in Philadelphia.
And what kind is it?
It's a financial firm.
Okay.
Yep, it just opened last week. We'll be up and running next week, yeah.
And how's it coming?
It's coming along pretty well. Still unpacking, getting things situated.
Nice.
Well, here you go.
Where my pills at?
Really bad.
All right. So, are you single?
Yeah, I'm single.
Okay, well, how about I take you out on a little,
You ought to be ashamed of yourself flirting with somebody young enough to be your daughter.
Ho. First of all, mind your business. Second of all, in the words of the great prophet R. Kelly,
preacher,
age ain't nothing but a number.
Hallelujah!
Unless it seems like she ready.
Amen!
You are too cute.
Oh, girl, I see you eyeing up my,
That is on us. Welcome back.
Okay. You'll be seeing me often.
Yes, okay. It was good to see you.
Nice meeting you, Chase.
You too.
That's why we're going out of business now. Everything free. That girl wanted you, man. She had that little twinkle in her eye, man. You should have did something.
I was just saying bye, Unc. Besides, she wasn't checking for me.
Man, she had the twinkle, baby. I seen it in her eyes.
That same trick of seeing she and you, huh?
Man, she's way out of my league.
Oh.
Why do you feel like she out of your league?
I'm in college, about to graduate to become a teacher. Not to mention I'm a waiter.
So what, man?
Yeah, you are a broke brother.
Bernard, last time I checked, you broke too.
Of course, I work for you.
I'm sure if she's interested in you, being broke won't be an issue.
I mean, she just seems like she got a lot going on, you know? I'm probably not enough.
Well, I'm trying to figure out what this bag is sitting here, because I know it ain't that weight loss stuff.
Yes, it sure is.
Especially in that amount. Why is it so much of it?
Listen, that is the answer to all our financial problems. All $10,000 worth of debt of it.
Tony.
Huh?
Did you get that from 52nd Street?
No, I got an even better club. I got it from Red and Terminal.
I thought you said you got it from Broad and Erie.
We can't afford to take no more losses.
Baby, we gonna be fine, I promise you, I promise you. Guess what? We got everything under controller. Controller.
You was asleep. Spoiler. Wait, listen. Did you see what Gene put up on Facebook? Girl, some things is meant to be kept private. I was telling people boys putting their business on social media. It's a mess. I don't know why. Listen, okay? I need you not to call her anymore. All right, we're not a hairdresser. We do not want to buy any more bundles of hair, okay? Thank you. Girl, you know them little hair pages on IG? They done got your number, child. You need to block them.
It don't look like you got much work done here today.
What? I've been working all day. You don't see these beads of sweat on my forehead? Look, look, right here. See it?
Let me show you something. It's Monday. My boss ain't here. I'm about to take another lunch break.
Let me see that. See, no, this ain't me. I know who did this. I was hacked. See, this ain't me.
I guess they hacked your Snapchat, too.
Look, so I'm gonna have to block you at the work.
This office needs to be in tip-top shape. We open next week.
Okay.
All right. Well, did any mail come today?
You got some boxes over there that came in.
This is for you.
What? I'm getting gifts already. Let me find out. All right. Look, I'm not gonna look for no more jobs at work. Oops. Okay. See, I thought this. I saw the printer, but I just didn't think this. You really bought me a printer scanner? What is this? What am I supposed to do with this?
You need to set it up and learn how to use it.
Oh, so you want me to print out my resume on this? What you want me to do? Yeah, that's what I thought.
My baby cake! Oh, can't wait to set this up and learn how to use this.
Okay, so should I look for a shower rod over there too? Because I know how y'all do.
No,
Mimi and Stevie. I got
no Nancy. I like taking pictures on my spare time.
Well, okay. Well, look, no judgment. I know how y'all do these days. What is your phone?
What's wrong? It's another box.
What box?
I can't move this box.
I don't know what you're talking about. There's a box right there. This box. Well, that was your
camera. No. I need this one box.
Where's some more boxes back there? I don't know. You mean this box right here? This box, right here.
Oh, yes, that's the one I've been looking for.
But what's in it? What's so important? Look, I mean, see, I was doing stuff all day, and you came at my neck. See, I was gonna file all that away.
I'll take this, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Oh, hey, you can put one right there and one right there. Thank you.
Oh, I forgot to tell you I ordered us lunch. It should be here.
Oh, good.
Oh, who are they?
Oh, they're installing cameras.
Cameras? I didn't order any cameras. Excuse me.
Oh, hey, yeah, no, I know you didn't. I did. It's all right. Look, it's just, you know, you got some expensive stuff in here. You can never be too careful, child.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah,
right.
You know, we in North Philly, all right? They'll fall bad and steal your last name if you let them. You know, you just gotta be, you know, precautious. Right?
All right.
All right.
Well, lunch should be here any minute.
Oh, hello. Hey, how are you? He is fine. Excuse me. How you doing?
Delivery.
I see. What's your name?
Chase.
Chase. Let me see. See, I was going to say something corny like you could chase me around anytime. I don't care though. You could chase me around anytime. How you doing? Well, you smell good too.
Oh, I'm sorry about her. How much do I owe you?
$14.
She got it.
You can keep the change.
I appreciate it. Mm-hmm. Nice place you have here.
Thanks. We're just putting the finishing touches on now.
Yeah, I decorated it myself. You like it?
Yeah, it looks really nice. I can see this being something big.
Speaking it into existence for me, I see. Oh. Haven't had that done for me in a while. Don't start nothing you can't finish.
Oh, you a fast one, ain't you?
So, do you do anything outside of being a waiter?
Late bloomer, you could say. I'm in school to be a teacher.
A teacher? Why a teacher?
Always wanted to make an impact in my community. You know, what better way?
Next teacher of the year, I see it now.
Thank you. Well, I have to go. So, hope to see you around.
Me too. Bye, Chase! Somebody has a crush on someone. Somebody has a crush on someone. Look at you. That's how you spell them all? Don't start nothing. You can't finish. That's all.
No. But he is cute, though.
He don't seem like he's your speed. You would date him?
Yes, I would.
I mean, you know, broke ones, they do treat you nice. No, because my ex John, he was broke and he treated me like crap. So no, I take that back. I'm sorry.
I'm no longer into guys with status or money. That's why I'm in the position I'm in right now.
What happened? Why are you saying now? Spill it.
I don't even want to talk about it now. Let's hurry up and eat this food before it gets cold.
Okay. Let me look in this bag. Open it. What? Listen, Beyonce wasn't the first one to do this. Y'all be on Beyonce. Listen, y'all be sick. I got hot sauce in my bag. Yes, I do. Always have it, always will. Open that.
How's business doing?
Business is booming.
I like that.
Yeah, they ain't want us to stay open.
Uh-huh.
So what we do?
Stayed open. Hey, Bernard, don't ever play yourself.
Drink responsibly. Gerber life. It's the only way. And another one.
We the best.
What are y'all rambling about?
Cloth talk.
Listen, baby. If me and Bernard here keep this pace up, we'll have this money in no time.
Already know.
I hope so, because y'all having a ball, and I keep getting notices in the mail, and I'm not supposed to be worried, but I'm worried.
That's called a major key alert. They want you to worry, so what we do? Don't worry.
I like that, I like that.
And another one. We the best.
Bernard.
What's up?
What about that time when you thought Mabel was having your baby? Because you sure look worried to me.
You goddamn right I was worried. I ain't want no baby by that cross-eyed Mabel. Come on now. That baby gonna come out looking everywhere. What the hell you smiling at, little lips?
Nothing, just in a great mood. Saw Paige the other day when I delivered her food.
You seen Paige? I know you're talking about my Paige. You must be turning to Paige. You must not be talking about my girlfriend. That's my woman.
You keep disrespecting me in front of my face.
Yeah.
I told you that's my girl. That's she off limits, you hear me?
You gonna mess around, be the next Soulja Boy and Chris Brown. And Soulja Boy's story wasn't real, mine will. I get the gun and be like, bah, bah, bah. Don't play with me, man.
Shut up before I you.
Listen here, man, I'm glad you stopped being scared of that little girl.
Yeah, you know, just had a small conversation about what she does.
What, did you ask her out?
Nah, she's way out of my league, man. She just paid for her food and I left.
Wait. Oh, no, you heard him?
You said she paid for the food and then you left?
Now, boy, why would you let that girl pay for her food? Now, not to say that that food was supposed to be on us or anything like that, but you sure should have paid for the food.
Well, yeah, she paid.
Oh, she paid for the food. Did she tip you? Did she leave you a tip?
Please don't tell me you took the tip.
Pause. Took the, you got a pause on that.
Yeah, she told me keep the change.
Oh my God! Woo! Why in the world would you do that?
I don't see the big deal.
I still got a chance. You done took the tip. Oh man. All right, I'm gonna be on your side. Let's be reasonable. How much was the tip?
I don't know, like $8, I think.
Oh, okay,
$8. Hey,
I don't know, but I might have took that $8. That's almost 10. That's $2.10 right there.
Sure is.
Oh, man, that's...
Leave him alone, he was doing his job.
Hazy, do me a favor. Shut up! We having man talk. That girl done told that boy to keep the change. He ain't never gonna get the draws now.
Chase, why you feel like she's out of your league?
I don't know. She seems established. There's nothing I really have to offer her.
It saddens me that you think like that.
Look, I'm a waiter. I'm in school to make maybe a third of what she makes a year. Not to mention, I'm just in college.
Listen, come in, son. That's the wrong attitude. Now listen, about 1975, I met Hazel, right? I didn't have anything. I just had 4 socks, 2 nickels, and a mean sex drive.
Oh, yeah.
Now look at us. You're still broke. But no, you got one more time. What I'm trying to say is, young man, you just gotta shoot your shot.
Yeah, man, shoot your shot, man.
Listen,
go ahead.
Shoot your shot. Mm-hmm. You're a great young man, and when you work on that self-confidence, you'll have it all together.
I know I'm a good guy, but I just think that someone of her stature may be looking for a more corporate type of guy.
Her stature? That girl from 22nd and Diamond. Is a hood rat, okay? I'm trying to tell you. She ain't got nothing but hood in her blood, man.
Man, let me tell you something. You take that girl to Bob's, or you take that girl to over across the bridge and Blue Crab, whatever that thing called is.
Blue Claw.
And listen, buy that girl some crab legs, you see how down to earth that girl really is.
Hey, look, you can end the night off, take her to get some hookah.
Show enough.
They love hookah.
They love hookah, man.
Chase, y'all both down to earth? And I feel like you should give it a shot. Y'all be great for each other.
Yeah, man. Next time you see her, I think you should ask her. All right.
Yeah, man. You should ask her out with the take out with the money she tipped you with.
Never judge a book by its cover. You'd be surprised on the way things turn out.
You're right. I'll ask her out next time I see her.
I can't wait to see that. I'm gonna put that on my phone, put it on Facebook Live. Everybody gonna see the little cute way to get his heart broken.
Hi, everyone.
Oh, speak of the devil.
Hey, you. You look nice today. Any new clients?
Thanks, just putting the finishing touches up on his new presentation for a new client, yep.
Don't worry, you got this.
That's so cute. Hey, Paige, how about you let me take you out on a date? I pay for it and I leave the tip.
Excuse me, Paige. Hey, Bernard, shut up. Go in that kitchen.
I know. What would you like?
I'll have.
Your order be coming right up.
So, how's school coming along?
Pretty good. I did really good on my midterms.
That's great. I can't wait to see all the great things you're going to do.
Thank you. So, I was wondering if... You ever make something harder than what it seems? It's someone you've been waiting for your whole life. Can't find the words. Ask them out on a date, or can we get to know each other more and become friends? I mean, women hear that and think we have some sort of underlying motive. But I have to try. They say you miss 100% of the shots you don't take, right? So I'm gonna shoot my shot. I was wondering if I could take you out to get to know you more.
I love that. Oh, let me go.
Great. Well, I'm off this Sunday.
Got a pen?
All right, you all set and ready to go. and that's on us.
No. I support black businesses. Here you go.
Thank you.
I'll be seeing you, Chase. Call me tonight.
All right.
Yeah, I see you, baby. I thought you about to drop the ball just now. That boy was nervous as hell. If I could.
She makes me nervous, man.
Hey, what happened? You said what?
Well, she makes me nervous.
Well, she makes me nervous. Oh.
Listen, man, the hard part is over. Just be yourself, man.
Oh, man, I can't wait till she break up with you. I'm gonna slide right in her DM. It's gonna be a slip and fall.
Bernard.
What's up?
Only sliding you doing in the DM is with the damn mop in the kitchen. Now get to work.
Oh, I'm so mad Tony ever slid in your damn DM.
Thank you. I lost service. Sorry about that.
You gotta get a better phone, because I don't have time.
Ooh. I can see why she hired you.
Okay, why are you all behind? And what's that supposed to mean?
Clearly she didn't hire you for your hospitality. Mm-hmm. You should have a little more respect for potential clients.
First of all, I am real hospitable.
How long have you all been here? You did a horrible job with the decorations.
A while. Who's asking?
Chuck.
All right, Chuck, how can I help?
Well, I'm actually in the market for a financial consultant.
You trying to say a nerd?
Word is, the woman who owns this dump is the one to get the job done for me.
Ah. Speaks much about you coming in here with that cheap suit asking about our services.
Oh, she is gorgeous. Ooh, where's this dump at? Hey, you know places like this make the best food? This must be her boyfriend.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I don't know. Listen, Wendy come on at 5 and I gotta go on my second lunch, so you got to go if you ain't doing it.
Whoa, I like that spark. It kind of reminds me of myself. I love that. Monday at 3?
Monday at 3. Now that way. Go that way.
Wait, one more question.
Yes.
If you had someone that was willing to throw you under the bus and cause you to lose everything that you worked hard for, what would you do to her or him?
I don't know. Maybe I'd get even with him or her. Or make their world crumble. You know, right along with mine.
My sentiments is exactly.
Whatever. Ugh. See, you don't know how close you was to getting tased. People with money be the craziest. Hey, look at you. You look cute. Want to take a picture? Come on, let's put it on Snapchat. Come on.
Still posting on social media, I see.
Listen, I've really been working today.
Come, let me show you something. Come.
Look, I'm tired of getting summons. I done got summons by this one and now you. Yes.
First tweet. I ain't doing nothing at work. I'm about to take another lunch break.
First of all, I don't talk like that.
Second tweet. I'm about to go on break and take another lunch break and get my nails done.
I'm convinced you a stalker.
Do I have any meetings set up for the rest of the day?
No, but I got you a potential client.
Who's the client?
You know, somewhere guy, but you'll see. Hey, Monday at 3 o'clock.
Did you touch my camera?
No, but that weird guy did, and you better be happy you ain't had no naked pictures in there. Not saying that I was looking through the camera, all right? I was just checking the quality of the camera. That's all they did.
Chase and I had the most amazing first few dates.
Wait a minute, the broke waiter?
Don't talk about my man.
I'm sorry, Chuck. You don't talk about my man. I'm sorry. But you know what? It's something about being broke that stimulates something in the bed, child. Woo!
You'd be surprised. The more money they have, the bigger the headache.
Mm-hmm. And smaller the...
Act like a lady! For what?
First of all, if you let me finish, I was going to say smaller the heart.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's such a gentleman, and our chemistry is like something I never imagined.
Wait, come here. Let me smell you. You gave him some.
No. I'm living in the moment.
Shoot, I would have gave him some. I don't know. He was scared.
I thought you said you didn't like broke guys.
Mm-mm. Okay, correction. I said I'd rather them be rich. But it's something about them being broke, and I'm telling you, they'll hump your life away to have somewhere to stay, to free Wi-Fi, and to play that 2K. They be there like this. You never said why you came back.
Oh, I just needed to get away, that's all. Just needed to get away.
I don't believe you.
Why not?
Because what? You look to the right when you said it.
And what does that mean?
See, when right-handed people look to the right, it sparks they right side of their brain, the creative side, and it shows they're manufacturing a lie.
What?
I learned that on Law and Order, y'all.
No, I'm just in a good place right now. I don't want to talk about it, and I'm looking forward to what's ahead of me.
Well, you need to stop chasing Chase and give him some.
Where are you going?
On my second lunch? Look, girl, I gotta get my nails done. I can't be walking around here looking like Myra, Sean.
I could use a refill myself.
Oh, good. Your treat. Come on.
You want me to pay for your second lunch and you want me to treat?
See, I could tell all on your face that you don't want to pay. That's why we need a union.
Come on, child.
It's just me and your girl vibe.
I love you, I love you! Ah.
Hey, Bernard.
What's up, Tony?
Has the new flavors come in yet?
No, not yet. That's top secret.
I like that. I
can't believe you two are actually doing a good job together.
Hey. Yes, of course. They didn't want us to win. So what we do? We win!
Listen, man, we're a little bit halfway over our goal, baby.
You guys could have folded, but kept pushing in the face of adversity.
They wanted us to fold. And what we do? We unfolded.
So, how's the planning for the anniversary party?
You know my fluffy wife, Hazel, she's handling all the details.
I'm just so glad it's not a going out of business party.
And speaking of party, you gonna invite Paige?
Oh. Yep.
That boy was smiling, wasn't he?
He was smiling, he sure was.
You hitting that, ain't you? Oh, he ain't gonna answer. That's how you know. That's how you know a nigga hitting. He said, who?
Hey, boy, just the thing, Bernard. You almost passed up on her.
I'm so nervous.
Hey, welcome to Tony's. You dining in or were you looking to order to go?
No, man, I ain't dining in or ordering. I'm taking out. I ain't gonna stay too long. What's up? How you doing?
Who are you?
Let's just say a friend of a friend.
Oh. All right. Friend of a friend. How can I help you? Friend of a friend?
Pretty good.
Well, God knows.
Well, you know, I like this place, man. It just look like you could use a few upgrades. Well, other than that, man, the food smells really good. Who's responsible for the food?
Oh, yeah, I'll be cooking. That'd be me cooking. I'll be in the kitchen with the stir fry.
Yeah, that'd be him. Listen, we thought about me and him. I was thinking about getting a few renovations in here. You know, getting new signs. Say T and I right here for Tony. And, get new floors and get new tables and chairs and things of that nature.
Yep. How about this? I'm going to help you out with that.
Yeah, okay.
Well, I'm going to make an offer. Matter of fact, I'll buy this place. In fact, I'll even pay off the remaining debt to sweeten the deal.
What we talking about? How much we talking?
Wait. Excuse me, young man. This place is not for sale.
Look, if y'all don't sell the building, I sell the kitchen. Shit.
Hey, I like you, man. I like you a whole lot for that.
Well, who sent you here, though? How you just here writing a check? Somebody send you here?
A friend of a friend, man. I ain't gonna say too much about it, but...
That's a generous offer coming from a friend of a friend. I smell gentrification.
Oh, yeah, that sure looked like a lot of money. How fast can you get that to us?
You got Cash App?
You can't be serious. Look at him in that fancy suit. Just stay the course. We're good.
I guess you learned that in one of your classes.
All money isn't good money, man.
This look good to me.
All you broke people say stuff like that. All money is good money.
What, you randomly drop in, offering money and to cover a debt you know nothing about?
Oh, I've done my research. I'm fully aware.
What, that every realtor is buying houses all over here just to move us all out?
No, I'm not here for that. I'm just sent by a friend to come and help out. Don't paint me as a bad guy. I'm heaven sent.
Sure. Listen, if y'all don't take the money from the man, I come work for you, okay? If you need to shine your shoes, fix your belt, I get that little curly brush, brush your hair. Whatever you need me to do, because I like this kind of money. I don't know.
Bernard.
What?
How does it taste?
Why does what taste?
His penis, bro.
As soon as he walk in here, you just...
on. Remind me to go to the supermarket and get you some penis pops, all right?
Now you said something about some friend of yours. Who sent you?
Paige Jackson.
Oh, Lord. Paige, you know Paige.
Paige know everybody.
Sure do. That's the Atlanta in her.
She never mentioned to me that she was sending anyone.
I bet she didn't.
Let me holler at you for a minute over here real quick. That's because some things aren't meant to be discussed with those who don't matter. Let me give you some advice. That chick is way out of your league. So if I was you, I'd stay far away from her.
She must
cut your losses.
She must have told you she wanted me, didn't she?
Hold up, cut my losses? I'm just getting started.
How about this? How about I add more money to your tuition? Is that cool?
No, thanks. I don't need your help.
Oh, no. You can use a lot of help. I mean, according to the dates you take her on. Man, I mean, she's used to the finer things.
You must have took her to get a wing bladder or something.
You're making this about money. You don't know anything.
How can you sleep at night knowing your bitch is the breadwinner?
He is cursing in our stuff?
Again, you know nothing.
You're in over your head, you know that, right? You're on the verge of being eaten by a shark and you don't even know. Just like this place.
All right, Free Willy. All right. Listen here, son. That'll be enough. Well, we thank you for coming. You can leave now.
I ain't here, no. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna give you a week. After this week, I'm gonna take this deal off the table. Hey, listen, my man, I just gave you $1 million worth of game right there.
Well, he yelling.
Next time, I'm gonna charge you for my advice.
Hey, look, I'm gonna give you my number just in case. call my phone. Listen, look. That's a lot of daggone money, man. You could take that money with the money we made, put it together, we could start a whole nother business, Tony.
I know that was a lot of money, but just chill.
Ain't no just chill. You gotta think about Pop. If Pop was here, he would have took the money.
Or would he? People like him come in neighborhoods all the time, offering a fraction of the potential property's worth just to knock it down and make triple the value.
Oh, now you want to use your big boy voice now, huh? You can sit up and help. Listen, man, just slow down, go fast. We just listening. We ain't taking nothing from that man.
Oh, man, you just mad because he came in here. He was telling you about your little girlfriend. Now you all in your feelings. What is too good to be true, it is.
Yeah, I guess just like all the money he's offering.
Oh, listen, that's a lot of money. We need to take it. What you need to worry about is cutting that little girlfriend of yours off. Ain't telling that man,
Bernard,
all your daggone business.
Bernard, leave that boy alone.
How the hell he think the guy know about him in school and he ain't got the money and he broke?
Bernard, leave that boy alone.
What are you, psychic? What do you know, Cleo? What's going on?
Bernard, leave him alone, Bernard.
Oh, man, I'm pissed off, man. But you need to talk to that boy.
No, Bernard, leave him alone.
No, what you need to worry about is taking that goddamn money. Okay? I'm tired of being broke. I've been working for you. You messed up my life.
First of all, Bernard, you need to lower your tone when you're angry. That's that short man syndrome in you, all right? Now, Bernard, we're going to be fine. Just stay the course. We're going to be cool. We're going to be fine.
I'm tired of this, man. I'm pissed off, man. Every time I turn around, you're making promises, telling me we're going to get money. We never get money. I'm still broke. This place ain't been nothing but a walking headache since I've been here.
Shut up, Bernard.
In the name of Queen Elsa, let it go. Cause we ain't gonna have no restaurant no more.
Cut that damn girl off, man.
Just thinking about you.
I've been meaning to talk to you.
Oh, what's going on?
We need some time apart.
Time apart? Where's all this coming from?
It's just with work and school. I just need to focus.
We can work around it like we always have.
Look, I just need some more time to focus, all right? I need time to think.
Time to think? It doesn't sound like you need time to think. It sounds like you're breaking up with me.
Look, my mind is all over the place. I just need some space.
right?
I have no clue what you're talking about. You have to talk to me and tell me what's going on.
Look, some little birdie told me that I wasn't enough, all right?
Okay, I'm confused. You have to tell me what little birdie?
Look, if you don't know, then I don't.
Chase, don't do this to me. I thought
I have to go.
Chase! Hello, Chase!
Open, so I let myself in.
First of all, that don't mean you walk yourself up in here when something's open.
I'm always punctual. Where's she at?
She coming.
Crazy bathroom?
Oh, now you want to ask and you done walked up in here? You know where it's at. Go ahead.
Right back.
Girl, look at this piece I got around the corner.
It's so cute from the little girl.
It's cute. It's beautiful. Yes. Look, your appointment was in here when I walked in. Mm-hmm, in the dark.
Wait, what?
Yes, in the dark with his feet up and with your camera, everything in here. Uh-huh, right here.
Well, did you lock the doors?
Yes!
Well, where is he?
Here, back there, going to the bathroom.
What's up? How you doing? Shot?
What are you doing here? What are you doing here?
Is this how you treat the love of your life?
Chanel, what? Take another break. I got this.
Well, I just came back from lunch.
As a matter of fact, take the rest of the day, please. Please, I'm good. I got something I need to take care of. Please.
Okay. All right. I don't mind going home. But I don't mind getting information either if you need me to.
I'm good. Go. You can go. I'm good.
Okay. Listen here, sir. Chuck, is it? Excuse me, I'm talking to you.
Talk,
hi.
Go.
Yes. Yeah. Keep scaring people like that, and I'm gonna put you in the first 48 myself. Make a plan. I don't care all that. You wanna play patty cake? Keep playing with me.
Oh. So, back to Philly, huh? Could pick an easier place for me to find you.
You better leave now, or I'm calling the cops.
You ain't calling nobody. Stop. No, you're not calling nobody. What's it been? 3 months? Where you been at?
It's over between me and you.
It's never over between us. And you know that. I don't understand the word over. What are you upset about? Huh?
You know what you did to me.
What did I do to you?
You put me in the line of fire.
Really?
Yes, you did.
Tell me how.
You used me, you put me in the middle of your insider trading with your hedge funds, fraud, and anything else the feds have on you.
What? How dare you? Let me ask you a question. When I first found you, you were in the slums of North Philly. I dug your ass out. You understand that? Tell me anybody else who does that. I opened up 2 businesses in your name, and I sent you to school. I'm the reason you have a degree. You understand that? And you want to talk about loyalty? That's all I asked in return was loyalty. And you talking all this risk stuff. What is risk?
That's how you feel.
That's how I feel, yes.
There was no loyalty when you used me. And then you put those businesses in my name. I worked damn hard to get here, okay. With no handouts.
Okay, so what? I paid a few people off to get information. That made us millions of dollars. Huh? What's wrong with that? You were saying that we was getting bags and going on trips. What's wrong with that? You have a problem being a queen on the chessboard?
Checkmate. I got all the information I need to get me out of this.
Oh, I know the information you're talking about. Hold on 1 second. Right there. There you go. Right there. So I guess now it's checkmate for me. So you have two options. Look at me. Number one, you become my wife and shut up. I will hear no more complaints. I ain't gonna let you know the next one. That ain't gonna work too well for you. You understand that?
I will never make.
Oh!
Say it again. Say it again. This right here. Chase?
Who do you know about name? Chase?
I get off the camera. I found them in a hole in the wall that you seem to love. That place is on the verge of foreclosure. You know that, right? No, 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 no. So I went by and I did a good deed. I made an offer to buy them out. I only did it as a gesture to show you that I'm changing.
I'll do it, okay? Just don't hurt them.
Oh, that was easy. That was real easy. So, you do anything I want right about now? No means yes, remember that, right?
I'll do it, okay?
Okay, no, no, no.
I'll do it, okay?
I want you to break up with him. And I want you to do it while I'm dead.
He already broke up with me.
I don't think you heard what I just said. You're gonna break up with him. I'm gonna bring his head to your front doorstep and frame it for you.
Okay, I'll do it.
Get on your knees.
What?
Get on your knees. Come here, look at me, look at me. You know I'm crazy. All right? Don't play with me. All right? 2 weeks. I already set the date. We're getting married.
I get my retro pay. I promise not to spend it all in one place. I promise.
I bet ever since Backpage done shut down.
No one is confirming anything.
So y'all ain't make no decision? Come on, talk to me.
Oh, we talked last night, and I think we have come to a decision.
All right, so what you think? What you think?
Well, he buys us out to turn this into a condo.
Oh, God, boy. You don't know that.
We know the decision, then.
You don't seem like yourself. You okay?
Oh, no. First of all, I can't wait till we get this money.
Why not?
Because I'm going to go straight to the bank, I'm going to bless the money, then I'm going to go straight to the strip club and bless the strippers.
You don't seem like yourself. Are you okay?
I'm okay, just frustrated. I haven't talked to Paige.
Gentlemen. Wow. Is this the lovely lady? You make it all work. Not right now, hold on a second. Let me come give you a hug real quick.
Well, that is true.
Ooh. Yeah. So listen. Got the deal?
Yeah, I hope you got the deal.
Little. Check his plane. What's the deal?
All you gotta do is say yes.
That's a lot.
Don't deny what you feel. Let me address you, baby.
Bernard, get your hands off my wife, fool!
Oh, man, I'm sorry. It'll shut Backpage down. Backpage down. That's the closest I get to it.
Oh, my God. Well, we have,
Paige, I just wanted to say I overreacted. Right? I just... Can we go somewhere to talk?
No, you cannot go nowhere to talk. Break this up. What the hell are you talking about? You want to introduce me? Never mind, I introduce myself. I am Paige's ex-boyfriend turned fiancé.
Huh?
Gotta put this on Facebook Live.
This is my fiance.
is my fiance. I wanted to tell you. I just.
What? What you apologizing for? You ain't got to apologize to him. Move. Remember that thing I told you couldn't afford her? I meant that.
Can't stop it.
300 views, we lit.
Stop.
Sucks to be you, Dunn. Mother died when you were 7. Your pop got shot in the head in the streets. Damn.
Oh,
you moved from house to house, and just when you thought you had something good.
Stop it.
I swept her right underneath you. Could never fill my shoe, partner. Now get it up.
I'm so sorry.
It's a deal, man. We got a deal or what?
Boy gonna cry in the car.
We got a decision. No.
I know that's right.
That was a very bad move. But once I take this deal off the table, like I told you, it's gone forever.
Listen, that deal and them pants you got on can be gone forever, too. Right? Listen, I'm not taking that deal, and if I had it all to do it all over again, I'd do the same exact thing.
Shit, well, if you could do it all over again, you would need to take the money, dummy.
Sometimes I wonder why you still work for your brother. I don't get that. Shit. You know the number one killer in business is pride and not money? Think about that.
That's deep. Look at you, philosopher.
Bernard.
What?
Take it, Bernard. Take it. Now give it back to him. Give it back to him, Bernard. Give it back to him. There you go. God, dog. Listen, come here, young man. These people like you with froze like that, right? Listen, it's crooks like you that would never make it. You would never prosper. You know why? I would have never taken that deal from you, brother. Not now, not ever.
That's fine. You're a fool.
Okay. Listen, man. First of all, you're walking up in here like you want to do something to me. Let me tell you something. Hazel, come here, Hazel, come here.
What are y'all doing?
We got everything we need and more, sucker.
That's cool, sucker. I know he bought the building next door. Property valued and already in triple. And once y'all drown in this situation, I'ma name this Tony's condo and remember this dump. Like that.
When I first saw you, I knew that you wasn't shit. Okay? Yeah. And now what I'm going to tell you is that we never intended on taking your money.
Tell him, Fluffy!
At all.
But when you drown, and you will, you're going to regret this. I'm going to personally make sure of that.
Damn, I wanted to work with you so bad. Damn, I wanted to work with you. But you being real disrespectful. It's time for you to go.
Hey, don't do that.
Oh, you strong stuff.
Get it up now. Come on, get it.
Take these damn shoes back. They said they was non-slip. I'm slipping all over the place.
He was a jerk, and we gonna get through this together. You watch.
Joe is.
Chase, you okay?
Can I take the rest of the day off?
Sure you can.
Hey, something seems wrong with Paige. Go call Paige. Call her.
Hey, y'all think I can take this check back up together and use it? Hey, what's the routing number on this damn thing? not Bank of America.
Yes, Mr. Jacobs. Yeah, we going to reschedule you for next week. Yeah? Hold on one second, all right? Okay. God, you got something better to do? No, Mr. Jacobs, no. I was talking to my coworker. She always on my nerves. Don't she got something better to do? No, we do value your business. Yeah, just hold on one second, okay? Oh, you getting fresh? Stop. You better stop it, Mr. Jacobs. All right, then. Hold on. God, he getting on my nerves. Mr. Jacobs. No, I was talking about my boss. She be getting on my nerves, dear. I know. Yeah. Speaking of stuff, Mr. Jacobs, we going to schedule you up next week, okay? All right, then. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Girl, that mute button worked, you know, when you use it right. We're not saying I was using it, though. I wasn't doing that.
Who was that?
Mr. Jacobs, can you answer me a question? Are we going out of business? Because I've been working on my resume, because I don't know what's going on up in here.
We are not. We're not going out of business.
No. Okay, well, that's the fourth appointment this week that I done rescheduled. I mean, come on, what's going on?
It will be better next week, I promise.
No, you got to tell me what's going. Oh, you're shining! What's going on, child? Oh, that broke away and proposed to you? He turned you out. He broke you off, didn't he? I told you the broke one.
No, it's not him.
Who is it?
Cash.
That devil. Why would you do that?
I don't even want to get into it right now.
Oh, this must really be bothering you, huh?
It's like, the more I try to escape my past, the more it haunts me.
Well, maybe it's something you could do to, you know, rectify your past, change your course or something.
I try everything. I'm running out of options. See? I thought moving back here would free me.
Yeah, see, that's the problem. See, running is a short-term solution to your problems, girl. Look, you gotta go to the heart of the fear to conquer it. Like that.
That was deep, Chanel. But no, you don't understand. He's always three moves ahead of me.
Maybe I might, you know, have a way you can disarm him for good.
What can you do? There's nothing you can do. Hey. And if you're thinking about killing him, that's not an option.
No, I'm not, all right?
Look, I know you.
You gotta play his game, all right? I mean, I was thinking about putting a hit out on him, because I know some people. You know, we can make that happen.
No.
Hey. Well, you can't go and marry him.
It's nothing I can do. I have no choice. He has to win.
Okay, listen, I could push him in front of a bus, but if I do that, okay, I need to know that you're going to put money on my books, do a hashtag free nail, and then you do a protest outside of the jail like they did for me, be like, free nail, injustice, free nail.
No, we're not doing that. We can't do that. No.
You sure?
No, we can't do that.
Well, what you want to know about Chase? Did you tell him?
Oh, my God. He crumbled right before my eyes. I had to tell him. He forced me to.
Oh. I wish you would have told me that before.
What did you do?
I ordered some food.
Oh, my God. He's coming here. I have to get out of here.
No, you ain't going nowhere, but I got my good waist trainer on, and I'm not about to eat all this food by myself. Hey, Chase. Right on time.
What?
I'm going to go on my second lunch break. Bye.
That will be $17.50.
Let me get your money, because I know you have to.
I don't want your money. You know what? I'll pay for it. Since I don't have enough money to keep you around, it's the least I can do, right? Have a nice day.
Chase, wait!
You know what burns me up? I thought what we had was authentic, not this fake act you put on.
There's more to it, I promise.
No, there's nothing more to it, Paige. You could have told me before we got this deep.
I couldn't tell you.
But yet you have me think I'm entertaining an idea of love you can only find in movies. But instead, I'm just caught in a web of lies.
I never wanted.
But instead, you have someone emasculate me in front of everyone just to tell me something I already knew. That I was never good enough. And that no love or money I have could ever be good enough. When I first met you, you told me that you truly believed that finding your soulmate and love in its purest form was friendship caught on fire. And by finding me, you never felt the connection burn so deep that you were reborn. We can see that is the furthest thing from the truth.
Is a hit.
I told you, you could have been listening to me. I told you I could always have business booming. I got all the right ideas.
Bernard!
What?
That wasn't your idea, that was my idea. You wanted to have a fish fry to raise money like we was raising money for some funeral or something.
First of all, I said a shrimp fry. You make way more money with a shrimp fry. What you doing counting all that money right there?
You know, I just wanted to count it one last time.
Oh man, that's a lot of money. You need to put that in the bank. Can't something dumb happen, you know how you do.
Listen, I'd be a mosquito on an African monkey if I let something happen to this much.
For once, he is right.
Listen, I'm gonna leave in a few.
I finally get that sign I always wanted. Oh, man.
I finally get to go to an island like Bermuda, put these athletes' feet in some pink sand.
You sure will, because I'll be handling all the bills.
Yes, you sure will. That's why I love you, Fluffy Wuffy. You know what I'm saying? You keep me in check, baby. Listen, this would never happen again. Not now, not ever.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's right.
You so strong, God knows.
How was your final?
Well, I got an A.
Hey!
Okay, have you spoke to Paige?
Nah, not other than when I dropped the food off.
But, that's terrible. Hey, what's in your back pocket? You got something in your back pocket, look like.
Oh. Got this for you.
Oh. What's that?
The hell you got?
It's $1,000.
Oh,
I saved all my tips.
That's a lot of $8.
It's not much, but it's the least I can do.
Come here, son, come here. Come and sit right here, man. We can't take your money. No, we can't take it. Look at them. Oh, we can't take your money. Oh, man, you gotta say that for school, man.
No, I insist.
Oh, man, all this time you've been pump faking like you ain't had no money. You just pump faking. You got a pocket full of money. I like that. You's a scam artist, too.
You talk to Paige?
Not since I dropped the food off.
My gut is telling me that something else is going on, because she really liked you.
Your gut is telling you need some of this gerbil life.
It's done. She's getting married. Clearly made her choice.
Chase, don't give up on love until it's over.
It's over, all right. All over YouTube, Facebook Live, under the pretty waiter get his heart broken by pretty Paige. Oh,
God. Hey, Bernard, shut up, Bernard. For our Facebook Live, my foot up your behind now. God, dog, I'm about to get ready to go to the bank.
All right, man. You need me to go with you, I'll be your security, all right? Make sure nothing happened to you. You know, I got your back. I'll be like your security.
Come
you
on,
know?
Boy.
I never let nothing happen to you.
Come on.
Because you my man.
Come on.
You Tony, my man. Tony to the end. I never let nothing happen to
all
you.
All right, everybody get up.
Oh,
get
Lord.
Down.
Oh.
Get down, man. I'm not playing with you. Now hand over the money.
Don't hurt nobody.
I'm not playing, old man. Don't
tell
hurt
me.
Nobody. Money.
Don't give
hurt
him
nobody.
The money.
Give me
the money.
I'm not playing. Shut up!
Okay.
Now you got 3 seconds, nigga. One.
Tony.
Two.
Give him
the money.
Give him
the money.
Money.
Just give him the money.
Let's go. Come on.
That boy done fought it.
Everyone okay? Everyone okay?
Huh?
No. Call 911.
Where my damn shoe at?
Took everything.
everything, Bernard.
Oh, you bleeding?
He hit me in my nose with the gun, Bernard.
Jesus Christ.
We done lost everything.
You can get it.
Everything we earned.
Only because you're stubborn, that's why.
Don't start your mess, Hazel.
That's why we lost.
God, dog.
You had the money in the bag?
Yes, Bernard.
You gave him the damn money?
He had the gun in my face.
Why would you give him the money?
He was about to shoot me, Bernard.
All the money we worked for, you gave to him? Jesus Christ, I told you to put the money in the bank. You don't listen. Now you're leaking.
You did the right thing, Mr. Tony.
Thank you, son. I'm about to do even right a thing.
What the hell are you gonna do?
Go get my gun. I'm about to go get it.
You had a gun here this whole time?
This is the wedding dress. You know, the wedding that's taking place next week? That wedding.
Well, isn't it bad luck to see the dress?
Well, I don't believe in luck. Besides, this wedding is happening anyway, right?
That's nice. Well, is anything you need me to do, boss lady, before I leave?
No, I'm good, thank you.
Okay.
All right.
All right, Mom. What's your name again? Is it Chuck? Charles? Chuck? Hey.
Chuck.
You do a lot of talking and bragging all the time. Mm. But you know, one day it's going to catch up to you like a punch in the face. I can see it coming. I can see it.
You know what? I was just about to invite you to the wedding.
Oh.
Like, I just wrote the invitation.
You did?
I just wrote, but no, you're not going now.
Not damn.
But I wouldn't see the punch anyway.
Right.
Too smooth.
Right. Like that. You. Yes. See, I should punch you in your face, but I'm not, because I'm a lady. I got ruffles on today. See you, boo. Watch out!
I would say fire her, but I don't want my taxes paying anybody else's welfare. Back to you.
Get off me!
Hmm. Get off of you? That's what we're doing today. No, come here. What's wrong with you? Huh? It's been a few days since I've been here. I ain't getting none of this. What's wrong with you? You got an attitude? Huh? I don't know why you're so upset. What are you so upset about? I don't get it.
You ruined my life.
How did I ruin your life? I'm tired of hearing this. How did I do that?
You're a con artist, that's why.
I'm a what?
A con artist.
So? Okay, so you're basically mad at me for making money. Because that's the only thing that I'm guilty of. I mean, me paying off some birdie to, you know, to get information for me, that's nothing. That's a part of the game. He who has the most information, they win the game. It's that simple.
It's against the law.
It's against the law. Well, I see it as an opportunity to make millions. If I'm going to pay off a little birdie, ain't nothing wrong with that. You understand that?
Then why would you drag me down with you? I had no clue what was going on until I saw the files, and that's why I left.
Ah, that was petty cash. Come on now. I mean, since we talking about criminals, let's talk about criminals. I mean, you ain't going to talk about the time I've been fronting your ghetto cousins to
Don't
sell
talk
hair.
About my cousins.
They sell, what about your little brother that keeps selling weed? And he want to plug in illegal fire sticks every week, and I front money for that? But I'm the criminal?
Yes, you're the criminal, because you put me in it.
I just don't get why you're so upset.
I worked so hard to get here, and I didn't need any handouts.
What?
You speaking to your loan officer. I am your handout. Have you forgot? I created this life for you.
You ruined my life. That's what you did.
You know what you better do? Be quiet, take this dress, and focus on your future. Here. I know it's a little off-white, but this is what they got. No? Come in. If I catch you anywhere close to that boy at that restaurant, I am gonna murder you. You understand that? Do you hear me? Huh? Yes.
Don't do it.
I'm just saying, if y'all would have listened to me and told everybody that Beyonce was going to be here, the whole beehive would have came. We would have secured the bag.
That ain't right. Shut up. Boy, that's another dumb idea by you, man.
Whatever.
I can't believe we closing for good.
Yeah, it's a wrap. Believe it.
Man.
I have some good memories in this place. Well, we got 36 more hours to pack all this stuff up. Let's get to work.
This was the first date I had ever been on, and you was the first person to ever take me.
I know that's right. You was dealing with that nigga Thurgood. So what? That same night, we went to 30th Street. I got you candles, roses, and candy. You know, you know you love candy.
A lot of candy.
It was so romantic, even after I found out that this was your family's restaurant and everything was free.
You got it with that one. You always been a kind artist, baby.
Oh, baby, you know, technically that wasn't free. You know how daddy is. I had to come in here and clean this kitchen and I had to come in here and clean this dining room and everything else for that free food.
Okay, but did you have to pay money?
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
Oh, it was free then.
Okay, you're right.
Hey, this is not a goodbye, just a start to a new beginning.
Listen, man,
Mr. Positive. Mr. Positive, you always positive about everything.
Listen, man, I let everything go. We got robbed and it's all my fault. And I gotta live with this for the rest of my life.
Come on with the pity party.
No. Is this true? Is this true? Is all this man's fault? That's why we going out of business.
Things will work out. Just trust the process.
Trust the process. We'll be the Sixers.
I'm so sorry I missed the party. I heard what happened. I feel so bad.
It's okay. God don't make no mistakes. You was not supposed to be here for that.
Well, I just came by to drop this off to you.
Oh, thank you.
What's that?
It's a little thank you note. Just open it when I leave, okay?
All right.
Page. Hey, baby, how you doing? So this is your last night of freedom. Might as well invite me down to the bachelor party. You know, I could be a stripper. I still can use the money. Turkey, take you out with $8. Come on now.
Well, I have to hurry and go, so I'll see you guys, okay?
All right.
Bye.
Bye. For a joke?
Darkness.
Huh? Where you going?
I,
A day before the wedding? What did I tell you?
Trip.
Ain't no business trip, nothing. You going to Dallas? What did I tell you? To death do us part. Let's go.
Hey, let her go.
Oh, oh hell no. Come on, go get them.
I've been waiting for this day since I got here.
Underneath the money and your narcissistic ways, you're a coward.
And underneath this, is a man you'll never be. And you always struggle with that. You weren't worth the time it took to make you.
Mighty funny, I could say the same about you. I'm wealthier than you'll ever be.
You must be on drugs.
See, it's people like you. When you lose everything, you'll realize you had nothing to begin with.
Tell him.
You know what, Tony? This is all your fault. After taking that deal, none of this never happened in the first place. You know what I mean? You had two restaurants. Now you're stuck with nothing.
Well, listen, if I should have gave you my hat, because everybody in here can see that sunroof on top of your head. And again, I never would have taken that deal. Not now, not ever.
That's cool. You're a foolish man. Hey, remember I said it was gonna be a little robbery in here? I mean, how did y'all fall for that, man? Phew! It's here, the look on your wife's face. I predicted that.
Just cut that. Maybe he is a psychic.
Maybe he is.
But listen here, man. Now that I know you did it, I should knock your head off your shoulders.
That's right.
But come here, Fluffy. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna have Fluffy knock it off for you.
Nothing good is gonna come to a nigga like you.
Excuse me. I'm a winner by design. Paige, let's go.
She's staying here.
You gotta say please or something. Please.
We're gonna try this one more time. Let's go. No, we're not doing this. We're not doing this. That's what it's all about now, huh? You see what happened when life comes at you hard? $700 an hour. I'll be out next week.
You have a right to obtain an attorney, and you have a right to have one present during any line of questioning.
What are you arresting me for?
I'm sorry, obtaining illegal information for insider trading, fraud, embezzlement, and conspiracy to commit armed robbery.
You ain't got no evidence on me. You ain't got nothing on me. I'm good.
$20 million.
Damn.
And I love it.
That's you too.
There's more. There's more. Oh my goodness.
Getting that little restaurant robbed by everything they had. That's evil.
Here. Take him away.
Wow. I'm gonna make you all suffocate from hell.
Hold on. Before we get to hell, let me get you something.
Get him, Bernard. Get him.
It's in my pocket.
Get him, Bernard.
Wait, sir.
Get me, Bernard.
Y'all thought I was playing. Y'all thought I was asleep. I was just playing. That's what you do when you see a bear. You play sleep.
Portia Watson. Listen, we've been investigating him for a year now. So we knew when you left that you had nothing to do with it.
I'm so shocked. Well, how did you know I was going to hire you?
Well, I studied your profile. And I knew that if I reminded you of someone, like your best friend that you lost, that I had a chance. And plus, I wasn't taking no for an answer.
And the files he shredded?
We knew that once he thought that everything was destroyed, that he would get cocky. We knew it. And,
so wait, you saw everything on the tape? Everything on the tape? Everything?
Hi, Chase. it is true what they say about broke brothers.
Told you.
It is. But listen, you won't have to worry about hearing or seeing from him for a very long time. Oh, and thank you. We got this for you.
Yeah,
we caught the robber a few days ago.
Praise the Lord.
Hey, excuse me, FBI agent.
Yes.
You know, I'm a broke brother, too.
All right, well, call me.
What's your number? 911?
Have a good life, everybody.
Thank you.
Don't even bother. You were just trying to protect me.
Y'all get on my damn nerves.
Do you forgive me?
Yes, I forgive you. I love you.
I love you too.
Open it up.
What's that? And the award goes to the D.
Oh, Paige!
It's
thank
the D.
You.
Oh my God!
Oh, thank you, Paige.
Captain of this ship now. We're going straight to the bank. No, you know what? I'm going to go to the sugar house. Put everything on black.
I tell you what. I'll take this and I'll handle it all.
That's
thank
right.
you.
All right, let's leave. Come on, y'all. They finna have sex in my restaurant. Go.
I love you so much.
I love you too.
Mike.
Can I get this mic? I don't need it. Good evening. Thank you so much for coming. My name is Walter Deshields. I'm the director of Chasing Cash. I don't need it. I can project. We do a little different tonight. We're going to bring everybody out one by one so you can meet them. Okay? So we're going to start with some of our stage crew. These are the people you don't get to see who do an amazing job to make all of this show work. So let me bring out Mitchell first, our set designer. He did all of this. Let me bring out Larnell Satchel, our stage assistant. Bianca, our assistant stage manager. Is our stage manager downstairs yet? No? All right, just give a round of applause for Kyra Knowles. She's our stage manager. She works up here. Am I on the cast now? Fee Goodson, my assistant director. Okay, am I on the cast yet? There you go, Kyra. Come on, Kyra.
Oh, sir.
Stage manager. Talia, you coming out? Yes. Brad's stepdaughter. Jada Kane. You met him outside. They worked under the house. Go-Go Leopard, our wonderful makeup designer. Aaron Josie, our executive producer. Is Crystal back there?
Crystal right here. I don't
know. Hey, Crystal. Crystal Belly, one of our executive producers. All right. Cast, I'm on the cast. All right, Jonathan Suber, our every person. Monique, where's Monique at?
Yeah, Mo. Yeah.
I wasn't here during this part, but I heard this happen tonight. So let's bring out Pierce Williams, there you go. He took his shirt off? No. In rehearsal, he took off his pants. He only had his drawers on. I said, we're not going to do that. All right, let me get Rosie Bond to play Hazel. Bad guy, Kevin Moore as Cash. All right. Miss Ronnie Graham as Chanel. Comedian Skeet Carter. Jermaine Dolly. Miss Aisha White. All right. Can I get some music for For our next person, here we go. We'll bring out some music. The man who brought this all to you, who met with me over a year ago, gave me the script, we worked it out. We did every line by line. We produced this together. He paid for all of this shit. Excuse my language, children. He got you in these seats, Mr. Brad Baker. Thank you guys for coming out, man. I really appreciate this, man. Give yourself a round of applause. You enjoy the show? You enjoy the show? All right, man. First and foremost, man, I want to thank God, man. Without God, this would never be possible, man. I really appreciate this. I want to thank my production team, my cast, Crystal, Aaron, everybody was a part of it, our sponsors, Foxbox, Glamorous and Confetti, who did this, King's Clubhouse, my son, his show, my mom, Tiffany, Stephanie, Ryan, Taja, everybody else, Tanisha, everybody else that had a part of this, man. I really appreciate you guys, man, and thank you so much. This really means a lot to me, man, and it's not about you guys in the seat. A lot of you guys really went hard for me, and and the stage crew of Suzanne Roberts, I'm sorry, and the behind the scenes of Suzanne Roberts, I appreciate it. And it's easy for putting this all on for me. But this really means a lot to me. A lot of you guys like, shared, posted stuff for me and commented. It really means a lot, especially you guys that have been following me through this journey. I really, really appreciate it, man. Thank you guys so much. Right now, I want to bring out something near dear to me. I lost a close friend and we dedicated to show him. His name is Dorian. He was real special to me, man. And he was really a part of all of this. I used to talk to him, he used to breathe life into me about this, and he was really excited when I told him I was really doing a play. And right now, I want to bring out his mom and his dad to honor them today. I just want to dedicate this. Your son meant so much to a lot of us. He touched us in so many ways, and he's not forgotten. In no way, shape, or form, I will continue to use this blessing and use you guys' blessing that you gave to the world to always keep his name alive. So thanks again for Dorian. Thank you so much, you guys. Me and Drew got here for 10 minutes. I'm going to hurry and get out because I'm going to have to pay more for this building. So thank you guys for so much. Also, I have my new book coming out, Twisted Her Life in Secret, which will be on my website, bradbakerproductions.com. And also, in the spring, look out, my next play, Letter from a Mistress, Two Truths and a Lie.
Let's go,
baby. Guys,
come out and check that out.
My first word of mistress. Thank you so much.
Let's go, baby.
Oh, shout out to my nephew, Dorian.